apple tries. Conditions are fucked up.
The Tasmanian South Coast, one of Tasmania's most rugged and dangerous, yet inspiringly majestic sections of coastline. Tales of shark sightings, ferocious weather and sheer beauty all originate from these remote beaches, cliffs and mountains. For those who don't know me, I'm Will, and I sometimes make videos like this one. In today's video, myself and three other young men hike almost 30 kilometres to dive these cold, dark waters in an attempt to catch a haul of winter crayfish. This journey started one morning with a phone call whilst I was studying.
Ooh. Yeah, hey, Geordie, what's going on, old boy? Yeah, righto, you want to grab a couple of crays? That's not a worry. We'll have to walk down to the south coast because the east coast is closed. So, yep, we'll just wait for some weather and we'll get down there. Sounds like a plan. Catch you, brother.
Despite the sublime conditions shown in this national park footage, the wait for good weather, with particular regard to swell size, took almost 6 weeks. Nevertheless, Thursday the 10th of August had favourable conditions and the decision was made to hit the road and to go on an unforgettable adventure. The plan was to follow the road as far south as possible to Research Bay, where we would camp the night so that we could begin the walk as early as possible the next morning. First on the mission itinerary was to pick up Geordie and load the four-wheel drive Corolla. Then we met Virgil at Huonville and drove south in convoy, but not before Geordie told us his plan to shake off a slight cold that had been hassling him.
I'm already a bit sick for a couple of days, so I got the old no sugar coke. It's good, fixes a cold.
That, with any luck, we'll sort him out for the walk to the south coast.
With Geordie's medical dilemma solved, we continued on. The adventure had begun.
What do you reckon, Wheelsy?
Looking pretty calm. Yeah, so right now we're just headed down the Huon Highway, aimed for Research Bay, where we're going to camp tonight and then walk into South Cape tomorrow. And the reason we're going down at the moment is because, as you saw, it's really calm. The swell reaches its lowest point tomorrow morning, so we're going to try to get into the dive spot as early as we can tomorrow. We'll probably get there like 10 a.m, get in the water, spend a couple of hours in the water, because then at about midday, 1 o'clock, the weather front comes through and the weather starts to crack up, and we want to be well and truly walking on the way back in case any rain and stuff comes through. We'll just push through it and make it back.
As we sped southerly into the sunset, Geordie and I couldn't help to become excited at the prospects of tomorrow's mission, and before long we had made it to Research Bay. They're trying to get you in. So this is where we're going to camp for the night, just down at Cockle Creek. Corolla made it, Virgil's Hilux somehow made it, and this is Cockle Creek. So if you have a look at this, she is pretty clear, which means there hasn't been much rain lately. What's going on, Virgil?
2 o'clock, eh?
And with those wise words from Virgil, we settled into the evening in preparation for the following day's events.
It's about 20 past five. Just waking up. About to start getting ready. It's 5:30, a bit after 5:30 in the morning. Geordie's up, making a fire for some reason. Virgil's over here packing up his swag. He's ready to get the dogs, I can tell. So yeah, finished packing up, hit the track. It's about 6:30 a.m. We've just started the South Coast track, about to just sign in at the register. We'll try to be down at the Lion Rock by about 9 o'clock and then to the dive spot by 10 or so.
Yep. And with a quick scrub of the feet, we were off and away. Another Another man who joined us on the expedition was Nick, who arrived during the night after the rest of us. He set a blistering pace down the track, which saw us get to the start of the south coast in only 90 minutes. And walking out of the bush and onto the coast was absolutely breathtaking.
That is the water! What the heck, what's the time, Geordie? We've been on the track for about 1 hour 40 and we're already at the coast. That's ridiculously quick. I did not think it would take that quick to get to the coast. We've made it to the coast. Good start. 12 minutes past 8.
And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen, the south coast on an incredibly rare day of low winter swell.
Interview time. Geordie, how are we travelling?
Really well, actually. We're ahead of time, so that's good. Lovely day down here. A little bit of swell, but the wind's down, so it's quite nice. Obviously, it's quite warm too. Got the t-shirt on, so.
So, mate, how are you finding it, Virgil?
Beautiful. Another day, another trade.
Oh yeah, far out. That's the way. That better? We're just down here at Lion Rock now, in the background. Walked probably 8k so far, just under 2 hours. So we're getting it done. Now we're gonna keep moving to get to the dive spot and get in there.
Oh yeah, Virgil's well happy, far out. Fresh water, Lion Rock, bit of surf.
But you can see in there, protected as. So we're going in there.
Oh, my feet are a bit wet now.
Bit soggy.
Oh yeah, give them a clean.
The next part of the walk involved walking over a large hill to get to a section of coast with the type of reef that crayfish like. We didn't realise how hard this section would be, and we soon found ourselves in thick scrub, deep mud, steep hills and rain. Our only saving grace through this section were the occasional views of the coastline. But once we had made it through this tricky section, a few short walks along rocky beaches brought us right to our dive location. Ah, at last, the dive spot. Congratulations if you've made it to this far.
So we've now made it down to the dive spot. The walk through the last little section got pretty rugged, pretty muddy, but we got through. It's about 20 to 10, which means we were on the track for about 3 hours 20 minutes to get from Cockle Creek down to the dive spot, which is pretty good. We were estimating about 4 hours and we did it 40 minutes left, so that's excellent.
With conditions at the dive spot looking safe for entry, I slid into my brand new wetsuit from Go Dive Hobart. I went with the Cressy Technica 2-piece 5mm and I was noticeably hot the whole dive, which is a pleasurable feeling in mid-August. With the suit on, we waded out through the waves and into the water.
We'll jump in and see what we can find.
As we swam out through the breaking waves, the cold south coast water grasped at our faces. Fortunately, the new wetsuit stopped the Southern Ocean's icy fingers from penetrating past my neoprene seals. I should also add that this isn't underwater footage of the south coast. While setting up my GoPro, rain got into the case and I couldn't defog the lens. So, this footage of a similar underwater habitat will have to do. Like this footage, the reef was dominated by bull kelp in the shallows and crayweed in the deeper parts, and these seaweeds came alive with thrashing movement with each larger set of waves. The dive itself was a reasonable success. After orienting ourselves in the stirred up water, we found an area with ledges and boulders and lots of crayfish nests. Among the nests were many female crayfish carrying eggs, which was great to see. The swim back to shore after the dive was difficult and dangerous, as a strong rip flowing along the shore had developed, which took a huge amount of energy to fight. Fortunately, no one drowned and we all made it back to shore. In the end, we managed to harvest 8 male crayfish, one of which was an eastern rock lobster, which aren't really meant to live this far south. Unfortunately for us, the cold, rainy front came through just as we were getting changed, which soaked all of our gear, making it heavy and cold.
Oh, the rain is hitting.
So it's 11:50 a.m. now, we've packed up. The conditions have started to get quite rainy and yuck, so yeah, we're about to head out. Just got a little break in the rain now actually, which is nice for video. But yeah, it got really, really, really rainy before when I was getting changed. It was horrible. So I'm somewhat dry, but we'll get on to it. Locked and loaded, Virgil.
Yeah, ready.
Oh yeah.
Well, a bit heavier on the way out.
Yeah,
loaded up, Geordie?
Yep.
Bit heavy.
Oh yeah. With bags now loaded with wet dive gear and crayfish, the walk out was no easier than the walk in. Hills hurt more, flats hurt more, and laughing at Geordie's jokes hurt more. As we trudged on though, a sense of achievement and an immense appreciation of this stunning part of the world was beginning to grow inside all of us. Before we knew it, we had passed through the hardest sections of track and were back on the home straight from Lion Rock to Research Bay.
Been on the track again now for almost 3 hours. We're not making as quick time as when we walked in, which is probably explained by the fact we've got wet dive gear and a few crays, but we're getting close. Probably less than an hour to go. With any luck, then we'll be back in the comfort of cars and, more importantly, dry clothes. But we're getting there. Team morale still there a little bit, but walking is spaced out and people are just getting through it, just trying to survive. Geordie's loving it up ahead. Here's one of the stars of the show, Mr. Geordie Bagger, carrying 5 crayfish. He's bagged them. How are you going?
Quite nicely actually. My feet are a bit wet, but other than that, I'm loving this. It's a good time.
Getting it done?
Getting it done.
The kilometres aren't hurting too much?
Nah, it's fine actually. Kilometres are pretty good. The energy levels are high. It's quite good. Yeah, just the wet socks are kind of doing me in a bit, but that's fine.
Yeah, no, fair enough. You were telling me the other day, Geordie, that you walked 20 k's sometimes at work. So
So for you, is this light work?
Oh, look, I wouldn't say it's light work because
You're not carrying all the gear around in the five crays?
No, I don't normally carry about 5 kilos of crayfish around with me at work. But it's definitely, the kilometres isn't really too much of an issue for me,
Wicked. Oh, great to hear. Are you keen to get back to the car?
Well, I'm quite enjoying myself, actually. So
oh, that's excellent.
Might have another run down to the southeast just once I get some dry socks on and
go back down to see
what happens.
The afternoon session.
Yeah, so get down there before dark, hopefully. So probably got about, I don't know, 2.5 hours left of daylight, I mean. And so I might try and punch down there and see how we go, though.
Lovely. Oh, good luck with it all. And here's the landscape. Virgil cruising along.
While weapons like Geordie were already planning a same-day return to the south, some of us were hurting. My foot arches were on fire, which I blame my 30-plus kilogram pack for, and Virgil's knees were hurting. We were also all soggy, tired, and fatigued. Nick flew back to the cars, so no one knew if he was in any discomfort. Judging by his pace, though, he must have felt great. In saying this, we are all so grateful for the adventure, the landscape, the company, and the crayfish. It's an awesome feeling when plans like this come together and we can make the most of the state of Tasmania, which we are all so lucky to call home. Memories of adventures like these last a lifetime and have to be done. To end the journey, we made it back to Research Bay, divided the hall and drove home. What an adventure. I'd just like to give a quick shout out to Geordie, Nick and Virgil for joining me on this crazy mission. I'd also like to shout out Go Dive Tasmania for gear recommendations, locations, and most importantly, their ongoing support of the state's extensive freediving and scuba diving communities. And finally, I'd like to shout out the Year 7s at Hutchins, who are watching Tassie Freedivers videos on repeat to get the channel more watch time hours so it can be monetised. Thanks everyone, and we'll see you in the next video.